boys, hey girl. I found this in the cabinet that Miss JB bought. Okay. So let's do this, but let's do it with booze. I got some brandy and I got some amaretto. So it got an icing. I ain't sure which would be better in what. Probably the brandy and the icing and the amaretto in the cake. That would change that, the yellow cake batter into an almond flavored with a drunk sauce on it, or drunk icing. So let's try that. We're gonna substitute the amaretto for the water. But you can't go all amaretto. You gotta half and half. So I'm gonna do that. Let me get started. So the recipe say to put the cake mix. No, that ain't what it said. What did it say? Yeah, pour that into a large bowl. A bowl. Oh, shit. I have trouble opening things. I pull too hard and go poof. And I ain't got but one bag. And I've been drinking, so I ain't gonna drive nowhere. You know how it is. Used to have drive-in daiquiri shops down the bayou here. And to stop all that, that sucks. All right, so put that in that bowl. What else? Okay, we need softened butter, fresh out of the nuclear device. It's all soft, see? Need a cackle fruit. One cackle fruit. Can you see down there? One cackle fruit. Got it. Red jam. Got cackle fruit juice on it. I say to whoop that together with a mixer. With an egg beater. Yeah, that's the word. No. Wait a minute. Got that? Oh, we're supposed to have a quarter cup of water. Bullshit. Let's go with a quarter cup. Well, about that much amaretto and the rest water. Now, you see in there? Got that. That gonna be good. Almond flavor. Drink what's left in there. Now you can freeze this. You can freeze any liqueur. It's about good to just take a shot of it. Like root beer schnapps or something like that. Frozen. Man, I had such a hangover on that some time back. That was years ago. I won't do it no more. Just don't drink too much. One or two shots, that's enough. Let's get our egg beat out of here. Turn loose, non-union son of a bitch. Damn attachments and shit. Look at this. Put them egg beaters in there. The whoopers, gotta have them. Turn it on and whoop it on. Well, you gotta plug some bitch in, don't you? Yeah, that may help. Let's get some power. See the whoop it on low. Ooh, watch that. Is that what it say? Always say to preheat the oven. Well, that's done. Yeah, whoop it around for a little while. Follow the directions on the mix. Come on for that. Well, we're gonna need all of you. I can see that. Now let's see here. I think it need more amaretto. Dump some more in there. What the hell? Got to be better, right?
Right.
Look a little too thick to me. Now let's see. Better. Much better. You say the, ooh, it got a nice kick to it. Give me some more. Put some of that Earl stuff on there to keep it from sticking. I lost my beer for a minute. You know, that was non-union. I hid it from myself. All right, let's get the batter in the bowl. You know what I like about this? Is you can always poke you some holes in the finished baked cake and pour some more of that liqueur on it. If you want to. A yum. Tastes pretty good right now. I like that recipe. It'll tell you what rack to put it on in the oven. Bake on center rack. Some recipes don't say this. They stick in the oven. Ovens vary top to bottom. Unless it's convection. If you didn't know. We make the icing after the cake cools. It's going to be a while. We can go drink some beer. Now while we're waiting for our cake to cool, let's go ahead and prick it with a fork. Why are we doing this? Pay attention. Pricked cake. Now, let's take some more amaretto and pour it on the pricked cake. Maybe I ought to call this video Pricked Cake. Wouldn't that be interesting? Yum. Want booze? Booze and cake with beer in a movie. Yeah, so I was just hanging out. I hadn't had nothing else to do. Drinking beer. And decided to make a drunk cake. Booze cake. Now, I do know this. After making it, because the alcohol, some of it's going to evaporate out. Not all of it, but you almost need to double it. Whatever it calls for in water, double it is using alcohol. And the amount of water they call for in this icing, that wasn't right. I ended up having to double that too, or just put, I added a splash more. It was just clumping up. It wasn't coming together, as you'll see here in a minute. It tasted good, but it tasted even better after I added some more alcohol to it. See, it ain't coming together. It's too crumbly. You just splash some more in there. It's probably about another tablespoon, actually. It's about double. Nice coming together. That's what you want. Here's a little trick. My daughters are bakers. After you get your icing on your cooled cake, make damn sure it's cool, but icing's gonna melt all over the place. take whatever you're going to spread your icing with. Oh, yeah, JV, you all tore up, ain't you? Go get another pop. Take whatever you're going to spread it around with after you finish licking the bowl, boy. And keep it moist using the backside of that spatula. Just keep it moist in some water, and that way the icing won't really stick to it. And you can get it spread nice and smooth. The baker's trick. Yeah. With that said, you can drink that water too, because that's alcohol in there. Put some ice cubes in there. Yeah. It come out good. I mean, it was real good. But JV said it was too strong for her. Oh, well. He also grilled some burgers and made a little salad. Make whatever kind of salad you want. Look, there's a healthy salad. There's some more health food salads. You like what you see on my channel, give me thumbs up on my videos, subscribe. A boy, a girl, a bye.